ZNS Total Sports is brought to you by Fourth Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Good evening, Bahamas. I'm Amajal Knowles with your Sunday Sports. Phoenix Suns center DeAndre Ayton continues to make his case for the top rookie in the league the first month of the season, finishing last night's game against New Orleans Pelicans with 20 points and 12 rebounds. He went 9 for 12 from the floor, adding an assist and a steal. Ayton has now snagged at least 8 rebounds in each of his first 12 professional games, making him an invaluable part of the Phoenix Suns offense, despite their concerning 2-10 start to the season. Now, despite another solid performance, it was not enough as his Suns fell to the Pelicans 119-99. It was the rookie's third straight double-double and eighth of the season. Phoenix has just won one game since defeating Dallas 121-100 in the season opener. Ayton in a feature matchup with the perceived best big man in the league, Anthony Davis, who Ayton has been on record as saying is his favorite player in the league. Over last night, Davis getting the better of the two, finishing with 26 points, 13 rebounds, 3 blocks, and the win. The Suns will face OKC next. Buddy Hield and the Kings taking on LeBron James and the Lakers last night in Sacramento. Hield producing 12 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 assists across 25 minutes of play in the 101-86 loss. Hield couldn't get anything going on Saturday as he converted only 17% of his shots and went 1 for 6 from 3-point range. He played well below his season average of 19 points and 5 rebounds per game, the kind of output that has given him a permanent spot in the starting five. He hopes to right the ship when the Kings meet the Spurs on Monday. University of the Bahamas Domingos playing their final of two homecoming basketball games versus the University of the Virgin Islands this weekend. Domingos started off a bit flat, falling down as many as 19 to 3 quarters before making things interesting down the stretch. Of the Domingos and this homecoming 0-2, falling to the Buccaneers 81-72. Kenzie Sylvester led the way for UB with 30 points and 12 rebounds. Dylan Spriggins led UVI with 15. Head coach Bacchus Roll on the loss.
It's a better effort, I thought, in the fourth quarter. Real, you know, we showed some fight, some grip, showed some pride. You know, we didn't want to lose both games this weekend, but you know, I think quick turnaround in games, the legs were kind of dead. The guys gave it their very best. We got some things we got to tighten up on the offensive end. The ball is sticking. We're not moving it as fluidly as we want to. But all in all, I thought we learned a lot from last night's loss, and we put it in effect today. And I think the score tells us that, you know, we played a whole lot better game today than last night.
Roll saying despite the losses, he does have some positive takeaways from this weekend's games.
It happens when you got to play back-to-back games and with young players. You know, what I thought what we did at the end of this game was we shortened up the rotation. We only played 6 players in the last, I guess, 15 minutes of the game. So we shortened up the rotation, really got the guys going, and got some confidence in the younger fellas, especially Trayvon Nichols. Like what we saw tonight on defense from him. Played good last night, but really liked defensively what he did today.
For players Justin Smith and Kemsey Sylvester, the size of the opposing team was a bit overwhelming, but that's something that they say they will have to deal with in the upcoming season.
Early that they were bigger than us, more lengthy than us, so we know we had to run and fight out, and that's what we did, our game plan. But because they had a bigger inside presence, it slowed down our game a little bit with blocking shots and rebounding.
Down at the beginning of the game, that really hurt us. It's like when we're down, we got to fight back, and then we got to fight again to keep the lead. That's one of our greatest challenges as a team, and also we gotta get bigger as a team, because obviously the team is bigger in these two game tournaments, so we must get bigger as a team.
Next up for the Mingos Night League action as their season begins next week. With a top 15 world ranking, local bodybuilder Teron Knowles is hoping to use some momentum from this year's competitions to impress in a stacked field at the IBBF Diamond Cup in Cancun next week.
Idea. Right now, over 250 people across the world globally, men physique short, I'm number 14. And going into the Cancun Pro Qualifier, I'm looking to probably compete against about 20 competitors. So it's hard and it's a tough road, but once you are able to break out of that category and win overall, then there's your pro card.
Now as for what it took to get to this point.
To be honest, consistency is key. I've always been one for persistence and to keep focus and to keep my mental. And my psyche all is one. So I'd say anybody prepared trying to do this competition or anybody who's trying to get into this actual feel of competitiveness to always make sure that you focus and make it a goal. And this is something you want to do and always stay grounded with God.
With Bahamas Financial Bowling League season underway, we caught up with some of the players representing the ZNS Hill Thrillers on how their season is going.
It's been going well. We're in our ninth week. Yesterday made 9 weeks since we were bowling in this league. And we're doing pretty well. You know, we had a very interesting night last night. We actually swept somebody, you know. So we played Rubus last night, and we had a very successful night. I was really proud of the team. Right now, we have 7 loyal members. We had 10, but some persons don't come out. But, you know, we want some more to come out because we really, really need some strong bowlers. But the ones that we have now, they're doing a good job, you know, and I'm proud of them.
And we would like to end tonight's sportscast by congratulating Shawnee Miller-Weibo, who last night won the Bombers Press Club Award for Person of the Year. Now, we hope that this trend can continue as Shawnee is up for the IAAF Female Athlete of the Year, and voting for that ends tomorrow. So for those of you who haven't voted, remember to vote and retweet on Twitter. And that's been a look at sports on this Sunday. A quick check on weather is up next.